A way of life, a way of life, a way of life, a way of life.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. All praise belongs to Allah and may His peace and blessings be upon His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I welcome you, dear viewers, to this episode. I'm your host, Musa Sarantonio, and we are joining our dear shayukh discussing the topic of the phenomenon of social media. Joining us, we have Sheikh Abdurrahim McCarthy from the USA, Sheikh Mamdouh Muhammad, also from the USA, Sheikh Salim Al-Amri from the UAE, and Sheikh Muhammad Ashari from Canada. May Allah reward you all for joining us. Now, in the previous episodes discussing this topic, we've covered many things about social media, the pros, the cons, how to go about it, to restrict, to allow, to monitor. There are so many parts of it about this. Now, I want to start a little bit with one of the, if you like, pros and how to truly benefit from it. Because as we've mentioned, the internet can bring good. There's no doubt about this. However, it's not going to bring good unless we actually know how to use it and we plan ahead. Now, we've seen, there's the term today, going viral, that something is just a small work of someone, but overnight it becomes a sensation. Sometimes it's planned, sometimes it's not planned. Now, I'm going to start with you, Sheikh Muhammad, introducing this concept and how maybe we as Muslims can learn from it.
There's two things about this. One of them is that Stop Kony 2012 video. The viewers might be familiar with it, but if you're not, this is a man who for 10 years he was looking at the situation in Uganda, and I know there's a lot of talk about, you know, maybe he was inaccurate or it's too simplistic, and that's not really what I'm talking about. But what he did is he made a video, a 30-minute video, and we were talking the other episode, the video should be 2 minutes, 5 minutes. He made a 30-minute video, and within like 1 week, 2 weeks, 300 million people had watched this video. Even the president of the US, he got his topic into the mouths, and the whole world was talking about this topic. Now again, I know a lot of people have criticized the video, it's too simplistic and it's inaccurate, but what I'm focusing on is that how amazing it is that he believed in something and he got the world to talk about it. And I said, how many issues as Muslims we have that we need the world to be talking about it? And if one man can do it like this, then what if we had an amazing Islamic message to get the world to talk about it? I follow the viral video charts. I actually, on a constant basis, I might check my email or something, and then I go to the viral charts to see which videos are reaching high numbers. And most often you'll find music videos. They get a lot of views. But whenever it's a video that's not about music, it's usually a Christian video, right? So one of the top videos that the whole world is paying attention to is, you know, a Christian poet talking about Christianity. Or another video is about Coca-Cola and their campaign for, you know, during the Christmas time. And I said, why? And I told the Muslim brother who was good in poetry, I would say, I would love to see you at the top of that charts. I would like your speaking about Islam, and you're just as good as that guy, but why can't we use this media to get the whole world talking about? And all these youth that we've been saying that are just hanging around, should we restrict, should they not? Let's give them some heroes online that they can champion and they can push it. We have enough Muslim children, alhamdulillah, yeah, to be sharing all of this.
Now, one of those videos you mentioned, this Christian poet, I saw this video. You know, I think it had, you know, 10 million of views in a day or two. So I said, let me take a look.
Let me just ask you this question, though. Why is it that myself and you, we both saw this video? And you can add that to what you're talking about.
This is one of the points. He had nothing to say. I mean, when you look at what he actually was saying, the message was nonsense. You know, many people made videos in response, even non-Muslims showing, you know, what he said made no sense. But this isn't the point. He was using maybe, I think they used two or three cameras, and there was no cost. I mean, I don't think there was any cost. The production was probably done, you know, free by someone, and yet it had this many views. So the message was disbelief. The production was very simple, and yet it was able to be seen by that many people because it generated controversy. And this is one of the things that we have to realize on the internet. Controversy is going to sell. It's just like the mass media. The news doesn't, you know, make money by talking about nice stories. They get controversy. Now, this is why sometimes we as Muslims, we might fall at the back because we want to listen to the Sheikh talking about a matter for an hour. There's no controversy. We're learning from it. This is the most beneficial thing. But it doesn't generate that interest. Now, I'm going to ask Muslims.
I would actually say as well, and hand it over to the other speakers, I don't necessarily agree that it's controversy that sells, but it's more emotional touch, right? Because you can get a video that makes you cry and people share it. You get a child laughing hysterically, it's an emotional touch, people share it. It's not just controversy.
Mel, I owe you for clarifying. Yeah, yeah. This is what I meant of just
an emotional touch.
Yeah. Something that grabs you. So, you know, as Muslims, do we balance this and say, okay, we're going to push the real knowledge to the side for now and just make funny Islamic videos, emotional Islamic videos? What do you think the way to go about this is?
I pointed out in the, before Dr. Mandu, we have to realize we're an ummah. We're not an individual, we're an ummah. We need all aspects as an ummah. When we can't say we're going to turn our back on the old way of knowledge or something like this, we need all aspects. And it's like Sheikh Muhammad was mentioning, we need these youth to be able to, and you see these heroes online, to be able to do like they're doing. And we also need the ones who are going to sit down classically and do it. So we can't say, should we leave this? We don't have to leave it. We can do both at the same time.
There's no dichotomy.
Yeah, what I'd like to say here, the news that you mentioned about this famous person or that famous person, we need to see what goes behind this. You said that the production was very simple, it's not sophisticated, three cameras, it didn't cost a lot, which is very good. And Sheikh Muhammad added the issue of emotional into the issue of controversy, but it's much deeper than this. And I think we need a team of researchers, how they call it, internet researchers now. We need to study this phenomenon in order to analyze it into pieces. And by doing this, we can do something similar to it, or perhaps we can add some other elements to make it better. So if we know the way, we can follow it. Yes. So, but at the same time, we have to teach all our audience. We remind them that the batil is always inflated. Yeah. So it's not a sign. But from us, from our perspective, we know that this is a success story. We can follow the same footsteps. Now, for example, Peace TV. In just a few years' time, they had audience of 100 million people. And even if they have some problems with some governments or so, but still they're affecting other people. So we can study these such phenomena. This is something very important. We shouldn't just speak about it without studying. And then after that, we can adopt them.
So no doubt there is a lot of benefit, but it's not going to come by accident. We need to be proactive,
yes.
Meaning we need Muslims studying in these fields, not necessarily just IT, but also in social media. We have, you know, classes that teach about this so that we can be at the forefront so that we don't miss out on this.
Yes.
Because it could be that, you know, thousands might embrace Islam through a website or a video or something like this. So if we're going to sit back, we're going to miss out on a lot. Sheikh Salim, you have something to say.
I have a question. What can I do for my religion? What can I do for Islam? We need all you guys. We need all the talents. Everyone can do something for Islam. Ask yourself what I am good at, what is my talent, what are my potentials, and utilize them for serving your belief. So he mentioned, now why those brothers who are, mashallah, are poets? Poetry is an effective tool, powerful tool. And where you can reach people's hearts and touch their hearts. And this is also an area that is very important, that the message touches the heart, always. So the moment you touch people's heart, they are now receiving. We have to take that into consideration. Knowledge in the life of the Muslim, it is the safeguard. It saves you from going wrong. So you have to have. The Muslim poet needs knowledge. The Muslim vocalist needs knowledge because he is accountable before Allah for whatever comes out. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Wailullah, wailullah, wailullahu, man yakdhib liyudhik an-nas." Woe to him, woe to him, woe to him. The one who lies to make the people, just cracking jokes, just to entertain the audience. So the knowledge, so if this vocalist, if this poet, if this actor, whatever, he is a Muslim and he has the knowledge, he says, I have to be careful. Because there are two angels watching. So if I say something haram, it will be written against me.
This leads us actually to what Sheikh Rahman was saying about the ummah, there should be, you know, people in different areas. But like what we see here is that usually when somebody takes one angle, Muslims start bashing each other. So they've actually, they've set up their dawah online to bash other Muslims.
This is a danger.
And I think that's one of the saddest dawah projects. It's very easy to do, but then they're like, you know what, you're spending your day and night trying to stop your Muslim brother, and the videos that are made are against this Muslim brother, the articles that are written are against that person, and you know, it's a really sad, and inshallah, after the break, we'd like to start discussing a little
inshallah,
bit.
Inshallah, may Allah reward you. It's been very interesting. Inshallah, we'll continue discussing this topic. So, dear viewers, inshallah, do stay tuned. We'll be back after a short moment.
Islam solves all of its problems.
Al-Aziz, the Almighty. Al-Wadood, the All-Loving. Al-Tawwab, the Acceptor of Your Return. Al-Razzaq, the Provider. Al-Raqib, the All-Watchful. Walillahi al-asma'ul husna, to Allah belongs the beautiful names. Fad'uhu biha, so call Him upon them. To understand more of Allah's beautiful names, join me, your brother Majid Mahmood, on my new series about understanding Allah's beautiful names on Peace TV.
Don't miss the chance to comprehend the seamless explanation of Allah's beautiful names in Understanding Allah's Beautiful Names. Tonight at 8 p.m. and repeat telecast at 11:30 a.m. Saudi Arabia on Peace TV.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm your brother Yusuf Idris, and I hope that you're enjoying watching Peace TV.
Most countries of the world ban bullying. They fight it in their schools and universities. A lot of us are being bullied differently every single day. Some come up to us and say, do this, while others say, don't you dare. Some say this is halal. While others say, nope, this is haram. Are you confused? Do you feel lost? Join me in Umdatul Ahkam, where, with the grace of Allah, we will learn the proper knowledge from the Quran and from the Sunnah, which would help stop this kind of bullying.
Join Asim Al-Hakim in Umdatul Ahkam, next on Peace TV.
Solves all of its problems.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back to your viewers. We're here with our shuyukh discussing the topic of the phenomenon of social media. Now, just before the break, Sheikh Muhammad, you were mentioning the fact that some Muslims not only are using the internet, they've decided that they're going to do something to work, you know, saying they're working for Islam. However, after all of this, they've ended up doing something which might be harmful or a waste of time, which is building websites to attack others, to attack other Muslims. And you say that this, of course, goes against the idea of unity, promoting knowledge. So you say, rather than, you know, having something which could be concise and adding, that's just saying, don't do this, don't do that. Now, this, of course, is a reflection of what exists in real life.
I think it's important here with the Musa that we point out something that any refuting that which is batil, that which is falsehood, whether it's from a Muslim or a non-Muslim, this is part of the deen, part of the religion. And that's why even Taymiyyah, he described the person who refutes the people of innovation as being a mujahid, a person who is striving to defend the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this is what Sheikh Muhammad means as well, is a lot of people who do this, I think the style that they use, it's not really what they say, because sometimes you see some brothers, might be saying the truth when they mention the mistake of another person, but it's how they say it and how they go about it which causes the problem and causes the fitna. If you were to come with a night, because we have to realize when it comes to the social media, there's a lot of people, even from the Muslims, who are astray. They've taken a path other than the path of the Quran and Sunnah. They've taken understanding to the Quran and Sunnah other than the understanding of the Sahaba. So they've gone astray. So it's important of the people who, inshallah, are trying and striving to follow the Quran and Sunnah, understanding of the Sahaba and the scholars of Islam, that they show the people this is not correct. And they show them that this is wrong. They show them this is innovation, this is against Islam, but not in a way that's ridiculing them, that's making fun of them, and causing more harm than good.
I just kind of like, just a footnote to what he's saying. I think, as we were talking in earlier episodes about the world has changed, maybe in the olden days, somebody could refute somebody and then they stop. Okay, life is not like that anymore. And if somebody comes on the internet and shuts off comments on their thing, they have to join the conversation like a mature person. And that's how, you know, you can influence on the internet. And I think Amr bil Ma'ruf, commanding the good, forbidding the evil on the internet, people are gonna need to be more intelligent about how they do it. They're gonna need to be mature. They're gonna have to enter the conversation and they're gonna have to use the tools, not just old school, just hit people on the head, and it has to change.
This links also with what Sheikh Salim said, the importance of Islamic knowledge. Because if those people do these things, it seems that their lack of knowledge, Islamic knowledge, and what to do in this situation, because bashing other scholars would defame or would affect the general picture of Islam and the interest of the whole Ummah. So if they have this in their background, they would sacrifice. They say that, I wouldn't do this. I know that Muhammad or Y or Abdul Rahim or X or Y did a mistake, but I would not make a comment in such a bad way because this affects the whole picture of Islam. So again, this is one of the basics of Islam.
Now you've brought up a good point here, that there are people who will dedicate their time to doing these things. No doubt we have to correct them, they have to seek knowledge. But then we already have the ulama and the shuyukh who have this knowledge, but they might not be present online. Now from my experiences, you'll find that there's a few shuyukh who are very, very astray in some areas, but they're all over the internet. So you see that they're using this media. Now, does that mean therefore that for those who are upon Quran and Sunnah, for those who are following the right way, who know the correct Islam, does this mean that we have an extra duty to promote our shuyukh? Or should we sit back, do nothing?
But I think promoting shuyukh, I would say no, because we don't...
Not necessarily shuyukh, but the right way.
The right way, yes, the right way, because then a lot of times this is what happened. And I'm glad you mentioned it, though. I don't think you meant it like that, but it was good you mentioned it like that, because what happens with the Muslims now, a lot of them, they become cheerleaders. Cheerleaders for their sheikh. My sheikh's better than yours, and they start bashing each other. And it becomes a big fitna between the ummah. We need to focus on representing the right way. This is important, no doubt about that. But like Sheikh Muhammad mentioned, obviously, the style that we use today, it might not be like the style we used of old. And you always have to look at how the true scholars were and how they dealt with the people who have gone astray. Because in the end, we have to remind ourselves, when we use this social media, what is our goal? It's not for us to be famous. It's for us to help the ummah. So you have to look at what you're doing. And you ask yourself, first of all, for yourself, what I'm using the public media for, or the social media, is it helping me as a Muslim? And then when you're doing something for da'wah, is it really helping the da'wah or is it harming the da'wah?
So no doubt there must be wisdom. Now, moving on from this point, because this was brought up in our first episode looking at this, and I think it's so important that we can't leave it. And this is the idea that everything you write can be seen. Now, I've said first of all by the entire world, the entire ummah, so we don't want to cause fitna, but it can also be seen by government agencies, for example. We're seeing increasing amounts of Muslims being arrested, being detained, being questioned for what they've written online, and sometimes they might not have even been at fault. They fell into the wrong circles and they weren't aware of what they're saying. Now, to quote a non-Muslim, I think he might have been working for the FBI, for example, he said the greatest blessing for the FBI has been Facebook. So I'm going to open maybe a controversial topic that I suppose we must remind Muslims about being smart, being safe online, realizing that there are people who might come online and they say, brother, let's talk about Iraq, Afghanistan, jihad, and then you find out that this person is actually a government spy. How can we protect ourselves and our children from falling into these traps? I'll ask you, Sheikh Salim.
Before we come to this point, Sheikh Muhammad was talking about actually a sample of people, a certain category who are sick, really they are sick, only targeting the du'as, those simples, those outstanding figures, to bring them down. And you find at the same time they do nothing for the da'wah, they do nothing for Islam. That's what Sheikh Muhammad is talking about. And here, if really one wants to give the piece of advice, we have to take, I always say, who is your role model? The role model is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There are manners of disagreement. Islam teaches us this. When something wrong, you address that thing which is wrong, not the person himself. As Sheikh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, he said, by Allah, we talk about people and perhaps they are already there in the Jannah. They are already there in the Jannah. حَطَّ رِحَالُهُمْ مِنْدُ سِنِينَ فِي الْجَنَّةِ They mounted and they put their saddles in the Jannah a long time ago. They are in the Jannah. But because they left heritage. And this is actually, you are giving them for their own benefit, the one who passed away. That you are telling those behind that not to follow this heritage because it has this and this and this and this. So it's not the person. As one of my brothers said, let us put the topic on the table and cut it into pieces, the topic, not the person himself. So always we have to address the issue itself with the manners. The Prophet ﷺ in many ahadith used to say, مَا بَالُ أَقْوَامٍ Not mentioning names, but he addresses the issue. He doesn't mention names, but the issue is addressed. So the message reaches everyone. One of the ulama, Sheikh Muhibbuddin al-Khatib, rahimahullah, if he finds a scholar said something wrong, this shows his smartness. How to give him an advice? He's alim. He would go and look for a book that addresses that particular matter. And he would give it to the Sheikh. Sheikh, what do you think of this book? What do you think of this book? And the Sheikh would read the book and he'd find the answer. And now came to mind, we have to learn from Al-Hassan and Al-Hussein. Children, when they saw an old man doesn't know how to make wudu, they made mashura. What do you think? What do you think? Say, okay, we cannot tell him you don't know how to make wudu. So let us make him the judge. They said, uncle, I and my brother, we disagree on the issue of wudu. We are going to perform wudu and you are the judge. And they started making the wudu and he's watching. And at the end, he said, Jazakumullah khair, I got it. The message reached. And subhanAllah, on the Facebook, for example, he signed someone will put a question and say, what do you think? What do you think? Islamic issue. And you're saying, what do you think? Say, ask, what is the Islamic ruling on this matter? Not what do you think? And you'll sign comments, I think this, I think that.
Now, before we get to the end of the episode, the last point that I brought up, just to maybe keep this as our last point, being safe on the internet, not just against deviant ideas or from fitna, but also, as I mentioned, the fact we have to teach our children not to fall into the traps. And we're really seeing nowadays, they are traps set by spies trying to convince you, you know, this and that. They might be agent provocateurs trying to poke the Muslims. How do we deal with these things? How do we prepare our children?
Yes, yes, I think here I remind the Muslim that the Muslim is smart, very smart. And Sayyidina Umar said, لَسْتُ بِالْخِبِّ وَلَا الْخِبِّ يَخْدَعُونِي I'm not cunny, but no one can play with me. Okay? So the Muslim is not that naive. The Muslim is not that naive, so you have to be very careful because this is a virtual environment. It's not a real environment. So all these questions, they come, they throw you the bait, be enough. Don't be like the fish.
I'm going to follow that bait. I'll give an example. Someone, you know, adds you on Facebook and he's got, you know, pictures of the Mujahideen and he says, brother, don't you have concern? Let's talk about this. Let's just say someone comes. What would you advise them to say? Would you say, may Allah reward you, but leave me alone, or?
Sure, I have a policy that if anybody calls me on the phone saying, oh, I represent so-and-so, and please give me your credit card number, or please give me this and that, you automatically say that you never do a transaction if they're the ones who initiated the call. Right? So if they say, I represent this phone company, I'll say, I'll call the phone company and I'll check if this is the file. So same thing with the internet. And I know you're talking about the issue of terrorism or whatnot, but you also have the issue of, you know, people searching out little children and all these type of things.
A lot of dangers out there.
Yeah, a lot of dangers out there. So it's like you should be the one initiating. If somebody's like sending a request, you have to be very careful for that.
We have to be smart. Unfortunately, we have come to
that. You have to be very cautious. Okay, and you should not be fooled and you should not let anyone to pull your leg. Okay, just ignore these things.
And me personally, like I'll say, when I see these pictures of certain people on there with people, I personally don't add them because in the time we live in, and like you mentioned, you have to be smart as a Muslim. So anybody who has a picture of what he considers to be a mujahid and what in another part of the world we consider a terrorist, and he's not somebody who's intelligent, honestly, to put a picture like that on his Facebook anyway. Or somebody who has a hidden agenda behind him. Yeah. He's either very intelligent, very stupid, or somebody who has a hidden agenda.
May Allah reward you for this. I wish we could keep on going, but unfortunately we have run out of time. May Allah reward you all for joining us in this topic, inshallah. We hope to see you also in our coming episodes. And also to our dear viewers, may Allah reward you all. We hope to see you also in our coming episodes. Until then, may Allah bless and protect you all. And I greet you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
A way of life, a way of life, a way of life, a way of life. Islam is a way of life, a complete way. Do you know what Islam says? It says that life's the greatest test. It says that life's a borrowed space, returned upon rest. A way of life, a way of life, a way of life, a way of life. Islam is a way of life.